vegetables and things might be available for
the little grocery
haul.
So I thought we would do with a little grunting boy.
With a little hungry boy in the background, we're gonna do a little grocery haul.
Okay, don't do that.
So if I keep moving around, it's because I'm trying to find a safe space to show you stuff. So let me show you what we got. So we got broccoli for 60p. This was 70p. It was an orange marmalade. We've been doing our shopping at Tesco or Sainsbury. I feel like Tesco has better baguettes and stuff because these are little mini local versions of the grocery store. And they have chocolate macaroons, which are tasty. But Sainsbury also has like, a lot of good vegetables and stuff. So we did orange juice with bits at Tesco. This was $1.20. And then I think this was about the same price. It was an exotic tropical fruit blend from Sainsbury. And then Tesco, we just got a little thing of milk. We haven't had a ton of milk yet because we've been so jet lagged. We have not been eating our normal amount.
There you go.
So I've also bought some Cheddar City. And this has just been going on our sandwiches that I of course love that I take out with us so that we aren't buying lunch when we're out at all the museums. I also bought at Tesco, it's 2 for £3, so I bought one chicken, one turkey of sandwich slices just for quick, easy. Give me 1 second, I have to get you a glass. Quick sandwich make, or even just a quick little snack because Abraham loves to eat meat slices and things. And I haven't had time yet to cook. Tonight is the first night we're going to cook. And this is our third night here. This will be our third night here. Yeah, let me get you some food. Now for dinner tonight, we went out this morning and we got the British fresh chicken fly. Simple. This was, I think this was £2. Not too bad. We also got a cucumber that we put on sandwiches. And we got Tesco's peppery bay leaf salad. This was like $1 maybe. It was really expensive. And that's been going on sandwiches or just this little side salad as we snack. I'm back. Whew, got the guy distracted with the cartoon. Sorry. Today is his day. Is this our third day here? Yes, it's our third day here in London, and the jet lag just hit him hard today. And yesterday, in like the middle of the night, he was up 3 hours. So he's kind of at the end of his rope for the day. So we also got some wholemeal bread at Sainsbury's. This was also about £1. So $1.30 or so is a good price actually for bread. It's a quite good price. Paper towels were not a good price. So these were, this is a Sainsbury local and a Tesco local. So smaller, more convenience store size versions. Just what's yours. I got the in-house 2 paper towel rolls, and this was £2. They aren't super awesome gigantic rolls or anything, so I thought it was actually pretty, at least compared to like Costco prices back home, pretty expensive for paper towels. Oh, we needed something. Who's so messy? The small human that's making sounds. This was £2, so we got a big thing. Can you get that? Not my focus, but it doesn't see my face. There you go. Pasta and just some easy shells. 100% Italian. Just because this is an easy meal that's simple to stick in the fridge. This was a great price for sauce, I thought. It's so funny what's a good price and what I find exorbitantly more expensive. Hey, bud, go get your glass for your chips. This is a tomato and herb sauce. It says bolognese, but it's actually doesn't have any meat in it. Yeah. Yeah, it doesn't. You were supposed to add the meat to it, which confused me because everything was a bolognese and, you know, we don't eat red meat. But this was just a really good deal for a whole jar. I was impressed with that because that's about a dollar for this. I didn't think that was a bad price at all for kind of these small markets. These were, I think, 30p an apple, and we got a couple of these to bring for snacks with us. And I meant to bring one today. I only brought us a banana, and I regret not doing that because if you watched the British Museum ordeal that we had, Abraham was just a hot mess from hunger and grumpiness and tiredness and jet lag. Like, just all came together all at once, and I just thought, oh God, I'm doomed. These lemons were 30p each. So not the cheapest lemons in the world, but I got them to go for salad dressing and stuff because we don't have time to get an entire bottle of salad dressing. And I can also just put this in some water for a water bottle wrapped because, yes, I put fruit slivers in mine so that I can be a perfect traveling Instagram mama. That's sarcastically, just in case anybody actually thinks they like that.
Mommy!
Please, you all watch this channel, you know the truth.
Mommy!
Yes, love?
Mommy, subscribe! No,
upstairs. Oh, maybe it's down here.
Yeah.
And then I got this is a pretty good deal. I think this was 80p for bananas that we brought one with us. Because yesterday was our first full day here because we got in on Monday, but that full day was travel. We didn't get into our rental until 5 o'clock. And that wasn't sightseeing, that was just traveling. Getting through, I was told, very unusually long immigration line and everything. It was crazy. So yesterday was our first like actual day being around here, and that's when I went. We need to get some fruit and some snacks that I can bring in the bag with us. I still need to get some more yogurt that we ate through, and I left the yogurt container out. I rinsed it and washed it because I was going to use it as free Tupperware, and somebody in the house threw it. I was so sad. some granola bars, but just having little handy snacks. I'm going to put these down. I think makes a huge difference. And this is all, it's so much less expensive if you can vacation rental it and get your own groceries and make your meals. I think we save a huge amount every day by doing that. We still might go out and get a special little treat like a hot cocoa or tea or cookie while out. But I try not to do that every day. Today we didn't, we resisted because yesterday we kind of got an expensive brownie at another museum and a hot cocoa, and that's fun to do, but then to kind of spread it out, it's a great way. So this is my grocery haul for Tesco and Sainsbury for here in the greater London area, and I know I love seeing these, and especially from a tourist perspective of what you get, what you can expect for prices, and you know, we get through so much food. What I've been doing is I've been sticking with just one. I brought a reusable grocery bag with us so that when we're through with that, we'll just go grocery shopping again because it's right down the street. I'm not trying to like bulk up and buy a whole ton of stuff all at once because it's hard for me to carry it back to the house.
Hey, mom, good.
Let's get dinner. Okay, we're gonna get dinner on with who?
Dinner,
chicken and pasta with a very jet lagged T screech and that pink insanity point. I love you, biscuit. Until my next video, hey. It means the world to me if you checked out links in the description box. As you know, I love to write my romance novel. It's my full-time gig. And I would love it if you went and clicked over the link. You can buy them on Amazon for easy Kindle ebooks. They're my other little babies. I think this crazy one is tugging on me. In case you think I'm spazzing out from jet lag too, or she's tugging on me. You can follow us along on Instagram with all of our travels. Oh my, this is his hungry attack. And I will always see you on this channel. Hey, thanks for giving me these thumbs up. I'm not sure why that looks so weird. And subscribing as always. Hey, I love you all and thank you so much for being a part of our Silly Billy Wholesome Feed channel full of travel and gentle parenting and breastfeeding and exercise and hey, how to have a happy family. Not just so your family's happy, but so that you're happy and joyful too. It's a pretty beautiful thing. See you all again.